Hi, this is Tim Shorrock. I'm here in front of the International Media Center in Singapore, where I'm working for Newstapa, and we're covering the Trump-Kim summit that's going to happen tomorrow. Already meetings have taken place today, and we will be explaining to you as time goes on what happens at the meeting and what to expect for viewers in South Korea. Here I am at the International Media Center in Singapore, where as you can see, there's hundreds of reporters from around the world covering this event. And I'm covering this for Newstapa and The Nation and my own readers on my blog. And I'm glad all of you are watching and paying attention to what's going on. Over the next 24 hours, we're gonna see what happens when President Trump meets Kim Jong-un, the chairman of North Korea. This is a very historic meeting. No American president has ever sat down with a North Korean leader. And this was something that President Trump was ridiculed for in the United States by a lot of people from conservatives to liberals, but it seemed like a brave decision to do it, a very smart decision to meet directly with the leader of North Korea to try to work out an end to the nuclear crisis and to hammer out some kind of peace agreement. There's still many questions about what will happen, but it seems to me that the key issue is, how will North Korea, what are the terms that it'll agree to denuclearize? And will the United States end its hostile policy, what North Korea considers its hostile policy? Somewhere between them phasing out their nuclear program and the U.S. ending its hostile policy, somewhere in between is where you're going to get an agreement, because the North Koreans are not going to do away with their weapons and do away with their nuclear weapons and missiles without some very strong security guarantees from the United States. And so that's where these two leaders are going to have to meet and have to hammer out an agreement. And I think, clearly the planning that's gone into this and the discussions that have been held between South Korean President Moon Jae-in and Kim Jong-un himself and the North Korean government have been very important in moving North Korea toward this point. And I think, President Moon has also helped bring President Trump to this point either. But this could not have happened without Moon Jae-in playing a very strong role. What they agree to tomorrow will be the beginning of a series of protracted negotiations that are going to truly move the United States and North Korea toward ending the hostility between them. And then that in turn, of course, will remove a lot of the issues between North and South Korea, so North and South Korea can move forward on their plan that was spelled out in the Panmunjom Declaration to completely end the hostility and start moving towards a peace regime in North Korea. So by the end of tomorrow, we should have a pretty clear idea of where we are.